Hello students, today I am going to discuss some HOTS questions from the chapter of arithmetic progression. In my previous two videos, I have discussed the nth term of an AP formula and the sum of n terms of an AP, and I explained a few questions based on these formulae. So today we are going to do a few HOTS questions. These questions are very important and often they have been asked in the board exams. Let's proceed. First, let's recapitulate. Now, for an AP whose terms are A1, A2, A3 up to AN, the common difference D can be found by subtracting the previous term from the successive term. So, we can say that D is equal to A2 minus A1. The nth term can be found by using this formula, AN equal to A1 plus N minus 1 into D. And the sum of n terms can be found by using this formula, Sn equal to n by 2 into 2a1 plus n minus 1 into d. And if we know the last term, then Sn equal to n by 2 into a1 plus l. So we will be using these formulae to solve the questions. Now today's first question is, find the sum of two middlemost terms of the AP. Minus 4 by 3, minus 1, minus 2 by 3 and so on. And the last term of the AP is 13 by 3. So we have to find the sum of the two middlemost terms of this AP. Now if I want to find the sum of the two middlemost terms, I should first know how many terms are there in the AP. But in the question it's not given. The number of terms is not given. So, first we need to find out n. Unless and until we know that how many terms are there in this AP, we cannot find the two middlemost terms. So, in order to find out n, we will use the nth term formula. So, here a1 is equal to minus 4 by 3 and an is equal to 13 by 3. The common difference d can be calculated by a2 minus a1. That is minus 1 minus minus 4 by 3. And on calculating, we get the value of D as 1 by 3. So now we will find out N by using the nth term formula. The nth term formula is An equal to A1 plus N minus 1 into D. We will just put the values. Instead of An, I will put 13 by 3. Instead of A1, I will put minus 4 by 3. And D will be replaced by 1 by 3. So we will get this expression. We don't know the value of n, so n will be written as n itself. We need to find the value of n. Now here we can see on both the sides of the equal to sign, we have 3 as the common denominator. So it can be eliminated. As a result, we will get this expression 13 equal to minus 4 plus n minus 1. And on solving, we get n is equal to 18. That means there are 18 terms in this AP. And 18 is an even number. So when there are even number of terms, we will not get a perfect middle term. We will get two terms in the middle. So the middle terms will be the 9th term and the 10th term. So the middlemost terms will be the 9th term and the 10th term, A9 and A10. And we need to find the sum of A9 and A10. So A9 will be A1 plus 8D and A10 will be A1 plus 9D. As a result, we will get the sum of the two middlemost terms as 2A1 plus 17D. Now after this, you just have to put the value of A1 and D in this expression to get your answer. This last part I am leaving up to you. You can solve it. It's very easy. You just have to substitute the value of A1 and D. I hope the sum is clear to you. When we want to find the sum of two middlemost terms, we must know the value of N. How many terms are there in the AP? And for that, we will use the nth term formula to find N. And after that, we can easily find the middlemost terms. Okay, let's move on to the next question. This is a very important question and many times it has been asked in the board exams. If m times the mth term of an AP is equal to n times the nth term, then show that its m plus nth term is 0. It's a bit confusing, but if you follow the steps carefully, you will be able to understand. Now here it's given that m times the mth term, that means m into am, is equal to n times the nth term. So we have to show that the m plus nth term is 0, that means am plus n is 0. Now here we will use the nth term formula, an equal to a1 plus n minus 1 into d. Now m times the mth term is equal to n times the nth term. So we will get this expression m into a1 plus m minus 1 into d. That will be equal to n into a1 plus n minus 1 into d. We have just put the formula of the nth term. Now we will multiply the m to all the terms on the left hand side and multiply n to all the terms on the right hand side. So on opening the brackets, we will get this ma1 plus m square d minus md. And on the right hand side, we'll get na1 plus n square d minus nd. Now we will bring all the terms to one side of the equal to sign. And we'll arrange the similar terms one after the other. So ma1 minus na1 plus m square d minus n square d minus md plus nd is equal to 0. Now here we can take some common factors, like in the first two terms we can take a1 common, in the next two terms we can take d common, and in the last two terms again we can take d common. So we'll get this m minus n into a1, then m square minus n square into d, and minus m minus n into d. Now this m square minus n square can be further factorized. So on further factorizing, we will get m minus n into a1 plus this m square minus n square can be factorized as m minus n into m plus n, and the last term will be same as before. Now you can see that m minus n is the common factor in the three terms, which I can take out. So if I take out this common factor m minus n, I will get m minus n into a1 plus m plus n minus 1 into d is equal to 0. Now this m minus n, which is the common factor, if I take it to the other side of the equal to sign, it will be 0 divided by m minus n, and that will again come equal to 0. So finally we are left with a1 plus m plus n minus 1 into d. Now what is this? This is nothing but the formula for the m plus nth term. So this is the m plus nth term. Thus we have got the m plus nth term is equal to 0. That is what is asked in the question. Show that the m plus nth term is 0. It's a very simple question and the answer is very short, but you have to be very careful while opening the brackets and putting the terms in groups and factorizing them. So it's a question of factorization basically, but it's related to arithmetic progression. Please practice this question nicely, and similar questions often come in the exams. This one is also asked in the exams many times. Okay, so let's proceed to the next question. Yes, the sum of the first 10 terms of an AP is minus 80 and that of the next 10 terms is minus 280. Find the progression. Now, why I have taken this question today is that this question is also asked many times in the board exams, and this is a question where students make a very common mistake. The second part of the first statement, the next 10 terms, here the students generally take it as the sum of 20 terms. But over here in the question it said sum of first 10 terms and sum of next 10 terms. So it's not the total 20 terms together. As I explain the question, it will become more clear to you. So let's take the AP. The AP will be A1, A2, A3 up to A20. Now here they have said that the sum of the first 10 terms of the AP is minus 80. So this sum, that is from A1 to A10, is minus 80. So I can say that sum of 10 terms is minus 80. Now let's come to this next part. And that of the next 10 terms is minus 280. That means from A11 to A20, the sum of these terms is minus 280. So how will I get the sum of the terms after the 10th term, that is from A11 to A20? Yes, we can simply subtract S10 from S20. So S20 minus S10 will give us the remaining 10 terms, the next 10 terms. So S20 minus S10 is equal to minus 280. Now from here we have to frame our equations. So S20 minus S10, instead of S10 I can put the value minus 80. So as a result we will get S20 is equal to minus 360. Now from these two equations, that is S10 equal to minus 80 and S20 equal to minus 360, we can frame our equation. So from S10 equal to minus 80, yes, here we will use the formula for sum of n terms. So from this first one, we can say 10 by 2 into 2a1 plus 9d equal to minus 80. Why 9d? N minus 1d. N minus 1, that means 10 minus 1, 9. So on simplifying, we will get our first equation, 2a1 plus 9d equal to minus 16. And from the second part, we will get 20 by 2 into 2a1 plus 19d equal to minus 360. On simplifying, we will get 2a1 plus 19d equal to minus 36. This is our second equation. Now we will solve these two equations just like simultaneous equations. That part I leave to you. It's very simple. You can solve these two equations by elimination method. And after solving, you will get the value of a1 as 1 and d as minus 2. And the AP will come as 1 minus 3 minus 1 minus 1 minus 3 minus 5 and so on. So this question also I have left a few steps for you to solve. That is, you have to solve equation 1 and 2 just like simultaneous equations. You can use the elimination process. After that you will get the value of A1 and D, and with the help of that you can get the AP. Now let's move to the next question. This is a very interesting question and very important as well. The houses of a row are numbered from 1 to 49. There is a value of x such that the sum of the number of houses preceding the house numbered x is equal to the sum of the number of houses following it. Find the value of x. It's confusing in the beginning, but if you read it properly 2-3 times, you'll be able to understand. See, there are houses which are numbered from 1 to 49. Simple numbering 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 49. And somewhere in between, there is a house numbered x. There is a value of x. In between, there is a house whose number is x. Now, they are saying that the sum of the number of houses preceding this house x. Okay, so what will be the number of the house before x? Yes, it will be x minus 1. And what will be the number of the house after x? It will be x plus 1. So the sum of the houses preceding x will be from 1 to x minus 1. So this can be written as x minus 1. And the sum of the houses following x, that will be from x plus 1 to 49. So this can be written as S49 minus Sx. I hope it's clear now. It's not very difficult. There is a house numbered x somewhere in between. And just previous to x will be the house number x minus 1. and just after x will be the house number x plus 1, and we get this expression. And according to the question, these two sums are equal. That means S49 minus Sx is equal to Sx minus 1. Now, in this AP, we can see that the first term will be 1 and the common difference will also be 1. And the last term, if we take all the terms together, it will be 49. So, with this information, we can solve this question. So, we have these two informations, A1 is 1, B is 1, and S49 minus Sx equal to Sx minus 1. Now, first let's find out what is the value of S49, what is the value of Sx, and what is the value of Sx minus 1. We'll use the formula for sum of n terms of an AP. So, we can use any of the two formulas. Now, if I want to find out S49, I will use the second formula because I know the last term, it's 49. So, S49 will be 49 by 2 into 1 plus 49. That comes down to 49 by 2 into 50. Let's leave it here. Now, Sx. Sx will be, we will use the first formula. X by 2 into 2a1 plus n minus 1 into d. 2a1, that means 2 into 1, 2 plus n minus 1, here n is x, so x minus 1 into d, d is 1, so multiplied by 1, it will be same. So this comes down to x by 2 into 1 plus x, 2 minus 1 will give us 1. Okay, now we will find out Sx minus 1. So Sx minus 1 will be x minus 1 by 2, here n has taken the value x minus 1. So, x minus 1 by 2 into 2a1 plus n minus 1 into d. So, x minus 1 minus 1 into d, d that is 1. Now, this on simplifying will give us x minus 1 by 2 into x. Minus 1 and minus 1 will make minus 2, minus 2 and plus 2 will get cancelled. So, these are the three values we have got. Now, we will put these values in the formula S49 minus Sx equal to Sx minus 1. So, S49, this is the value, 49 by 2 into 50, S49, minus Sx, this is the value, x by 2 into 1 plus x, so minus Sx, is equal to Sx minus 1, Sx minus 1 is this value, so equal to x minus 1 by 2 into x. So, we have put the values in the expression which we got. Now, you can see that on both the sides of the equal to side, 2 is the common denominator which can be eliminated. So, on simplifying we will get 49 into 50, that is 2450, minus x minus x square, I am opening the brackets, is equal to x square minus x. On both the sides minus x will get eliminated and we will get 2x square equal to 2450. Which on simplification gives x square is 1225. Now, 1225 is a perfect square. It is the square root of, it is the square of 35. So, x will be the square root of 1225, that is 35. That means the value of x, that house number x is actually 35. So, you can see initially the sum was a bit complicated, but after we broke it into parts and interpreted it in with the help of the formula, it has become quite simple. Now, these four questions which I have discussed today are very, very important, and if you find my video helpful, then please subscribe to my channel and share my video with your friends. And if you feel that it is helpful, you can write in the comments.